Chapter 6, Section 4, The Effect of the War on Soldiers. Around 3 million men fought in the Civil War. As many as a third of these soldiers died or were wounded in battle. Even for those who escaped without injury, the war exacted tremendous cost. Soldiers had to leave their homes and families for up to 4 years while enduring numerous hardships. New weapons make battle more deadly. The Civil War was an extremely brutal and destructive conflict. One reason for this was the development of new and deadlier weapons, such as the rifled musket. Unlike the old smoothbore musket, this gun had grooves on the inside of the barrel that caused the bullet to spin, allowing it to travel much faster, farther, and with greater accuracy. Improved cannons with explosive shells also allowed armies to unleash a hail of artillery fire on their opponents. These new weapons were deadly enough, but poor battlefield tactics exacerbated their effects. Instead of spreading troops out to make them difficult to target, generals massed the soldiers together for large frontal assaults on enemy lines. This tactic had worked well enough in previous wars, when guns were less accurate, but in the Civil War, snipers who were dug into defensive positions could mow down a line of charging troops with ease, even at great distances. This mismatch of new weapons with old tactics led to incredibly bloody battles, like the one at Antietam. Civil War battles were typically chaotic, terrifying events. 50 years later, a former soldier could still recall the awful sound of battle. The screaming and bursting of shells, the death screams of wounded animals, the groans of their human companions, wounded and dying and trampled underfoot by hurrying batteries, riderless horses, and the moving lines of battle. A perfect hell on earth. Unknown Union soldier describing the Battle of Gettysburg. Battles often took place in open fields, but sometimes, as the following soldier describes, the battles occurred in wooded areas where the enemy was hard to spot. No one could see the fight 50 feet from him. The lines were very near each other, and from the dense underbrush and the tops of trees came puffs of smoke. The ping of the bullets and the yell of the enemy, it was a blind and bloody hunt to the death in bewildering thickets rather than a battle. Unknown Union soldier describing the Battle of the Wilderness, 1864. Although men on both sides fought with courage, it was a rare soldier who eagerly sought conflict. As one put it, when bullets are whacking against tree trunks and solid shots are cracking skulls like eggshells, the consuming passion in the breast of the average man is to get out of the way. Medical care on the battlefield. Many soldiers who were wounded in battle died where they fell. Those who were rescued often faced a grim fate in the hands of military doctors. In the 1860s, medical knowledge was quite limited. Doctors did not know how to treat many diseases, nor did they understand the causes of infection and the need for sanitary procedures and surgery. Battlefield surgeons often worked in clothes covered with blood. They wiped their hands and surgical tools on their jackets or dipped them in dirty water between operations. One of their most common tools was the bone saw, which was used to perform amputations. Because musket balls typically shatter bones on impact, doctors had little recourse but to remove whole limbs, often without anesthesia. Piles of arms, legs, and feet would stack up outside medical tents. Poor hygiene was another major problem in camp. Soldiers often pitched their tents near open latrines and bathed in the same water that they used for drinking. These practices encouraged the spread of disease. For every soldier who died in battle, an estimated 2 or 3 more died of disease from unsanitary conditions in camp. Keeping busy between battles. The life of soldiers was not all about the horrors of war. Most of their time was spent away from combat. On average, for every day of battle, they spent 50 days hanging out around camp. When they were not marching or drilling, the men usually had a lot of time on their hands. To stay occupied in camp, soldiers on both sides pursued various pastimes. Reading was a common activity. Many soldiers were particularly interested in newspapers from home. Soldiers also wrote letters to their loved ones, played cards, and went swimming. Hunting and fishing were popular, as were sports like baseball and wrestling. Soldiers even performed magic shows, skits, and plays for their campmates. One Confederate production called Medical Board satirized Army doctors and their fondness for amputation. Music played a special part in the lives of soldiers. To raise their spirits before battle, they sang patriotic songs like The Battle Cry of Freedom and Dixie. Most of the time, however, they preferred traditional folk songs and sentimental ballads. They also made up songs about the hardships of war and the tedium of camp life. One mournful song, Weeping Sad and Lonely, was a favorite among homesick troops on both sides.
Weeping sad and lonely, hopes and fears
Henry Tucker, 1863. When Union and Confederate forces were camped near each other, as sometimes happened, troops from both armies might even join in songs together, their voices echoing across the distance between their camps.